It's all down there. I tell you what, you know, do you really think that you can achieve God's pristine standard of perfection? No. That's way up there.
Nope.
Only Jesus did. Only Jesus can. Amen.
Amen.
And so that's why in Him, God gives you an A plus for law keeping. Amen. Because He's not looking at you as you. He's looking at the perfect man at His right hand as you. He's your lamb. Even under the old covenant, they looked at the lamb, not the offerer. They looked at the offering. Who's your offering? Jesus. So why are you so concerned with yourself? 1 John 1:17 says, as He is, so am I in this world. But so many believers, they come to God and say, God, as I am, so am I in this world. Now will You answer this prayer? And they think that God can be obliged or persuaded when He loves you, He moves for you. Why? Because He loves you. Amen. And when He looks at you in Christ, He looks at you just like He looks at Jesus. Amen. Perfect. Without spot, without blemish. That's how He sees the church. Amen.
Amen.
Even Jesus, He said, don't look at the wood in your brother's eye. But yet preachers are preaching to the church like they're wood. When we need to be preaching to the people like they're gold. Amen. And I tell you, when you know who you are in Christ, then you become victorious. Because even Paul's way of correcting the Corinthian church, the most corrupt church, his way of correcting them was this. He said, don't you know you are the temple of the living God? I tell you today, many people say, don't you know you're supposed to be? Paul said, don't you know you are? Now you know who you are. Why would you unite the temple with the harlot? He said, don't you know who you are? And I tell you, this is God's way of instructing, correcting. But what about chastisement? God loves those, chastises those He loves. I'm glad you asked that one, too. Thanks for asking. You know, that word chastise in Hebrews 12 is the word paideia. And it literally means child train to instruct with words. Right now, paideia is going forth. Amen. Instructing with words. You know, God doesn't send calamity or take provision from you to teach people lessons. I tell you, if that's true, we should see Jesus doing that at least one time in the Gospels. Because our Bible says that Jesus is the very image of the invisible God. The disciples said, show us the Father. Jesus said, you see Me, you see the Father. Mm-hmm. And so if that's true, we should see Jesus doing it at least one time. Otherwise, and I say this most reverently, we were done a big disservice by Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John that was left out. Because He doesn't do those things. Who's the destroyer? Who's the killer? Who's the thief? I tell you what, you know, Jesus diagnoses when people know they're forgiven much. He says they love much. But man's logic says, oh, don't preach this way, the people are going to go wild. When they're already going wild. So they're already doing that, Pastor. So, you know, but I tell you what, you know, there's times, and this is what I tell people today, if they have a problem with smoking cigarettes, you know, and they want to quit, I direct them, even if they watch pornography, I tell them, I say, you know what, you have a problem with that, while you are watching or while you are smoking, say this. Say, I am the righteousness of God in Jesus Christ. While you are doing it. Amen. Mm-hmm. Confess it. I tell you, us charismatics, we say, if your shoulder hurts, don't claim it. Keep on claiming that you're healed. If you have a sickness, don't claim it. Keep on saying you're healed. Well, what about a sin problem then? I tell you, don't claim it. Keep proclaiming your righteousness. And guess what? What you confess out of your mouth is going to drop into your heart.
Come on.
Amen. And we had one brother, many testimonies, stand here and testify after smoking for 18 years. He said, I would do that. It's like Pastor Quincy directed. He said, now, after 18 years, I'm smoke-free.
Amen.
Amen. And many people, I tell you what, many people coming and getting healed of cancer. We just read some more testimonies last night. Last night, a testimony went forth of a woman healed of diabetes, and all confirmed by the hospital. Some had actual letters reading through the church. All because they weren't trying to earn their healing. They're saying, you know what? I don't deserve it, but I receive grace because why? I'm undeserving. And here comes the supply.
Amen.
Because I tell you this, you can't earn something that's undeserved. When people are trying to earn their healing, I tell you, this is, you know why God hates hypocrites? Or I shouldn't say hates them, but hates hypocrisy. It's because they will never know how loved they are. This is why the woman who touched Jesus' hem of his garment, Jesus stopped. And he turned around. You know why? Because if he didn't stop, if he didn't turn around, that woman would never know that she's loved. She would live the rest of her life thinking, I stole a blessing. I made it through the crowd. And I touched them all my I. When Jesus turned around and said, no, you didn't take nothing from me. And had a private moment in the midst of the crowd. Just for her. Amazing. And I tell you, you notice this. Everybody who testifies of being healed, getting provided for, they all say the same thing. I told the Lord, I can't do it anymore. I told the Lord, I give up. Right when they laid down their self-efforts, here comes the supply.
Yeah.
Amazing. Even Abraham, after he, Ishmael was born out of self-effort. Abraham, 13 years later, after he was even older, came to the end of himself, and now here comes the promise. We always say, Jesus gets all the glory. Why? Because he does all the work. Amen. And I tell you what, our part is to receive, and then your work is just a byproduct of your seeing him. And now, you're more powerful than you once were, because now you are, and you're living a carefree life of peace that's natural, and you're not trying to become, you are. You see? And I tell you what, that's the gospel. And that's even the Jew even takes it further. They say, well, why should I come over to Christianity? Because I already have Yahweh. You're telling me to keep the law. I already have the law. So why should I come over? I tell you, it's because we're not preaching the much more of what Jesus has done. Justification by faith, righteous by believing. Amen.
Amen.
Apart from works, being delivered from the law. Amazing. Even well-meaning preachers are saying, the just live by faith. We all live by faith. And then telling you to keep the law. When the scripture says, the law is not of faith. Whoa. I tell you, mixture is always, is confusion. And I tell you what, there's a reformation happening in the body of Christ.
Yes.
All
Amen.
Over the world.
Amen.
And God is calling the body of Christ out of mixture.
Yes.
Into the pure gospel of grace that it is.
Amen.
Amen. I tell you what, you know, it was Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones. He said that Paul was accused of preaching so much grace that people thought, oh, he's telling people they can do whatever they want. And then Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones said this. He said, if we're preaching the same gospel that Paul is preaching, then us too, we should have that accusation rallied against us. Praise the Lord, we have at the Miracle Center. And I tell you what, you know, any church preaching the new covenant with no mixture, God will supply that church. God will supply that ministry. Amen. I tell you what, you know, we're a small church, but I tell people we're a small church, but we're a great and loving church. And very interesting, I was sharing this with our church about this past week, that there is one item in the tabernacle that God gives no dimensions for, and that's the lampstand. And God says in Revelation that the lampstand represents the church. And that's something. It gives no dimensions for it. It doesn't matter how big it is. You know, he uses the smallest plurality, two, to qualify us to have church. And by the way, you are the church having church. Amen. But it doesn't give the dimensions for the lampstand, but it does give something about the lampstand. And you know what that is? The weight of it. You hear that? The influence of it. And the Miracle Center's messages, they are requested in India. They are requested in South Africa. And the Blue Road started right here. And going out all over the country and in Canada. And I tell you what, and like I said, we have no connections. We started out in a denomination, and we're non-denominational. So we don't have anybody pumping funds into the church, but the Miracle Center is not lacking for anything. And the Miracle Center's accounts are very full. Amen. All by the grace of Jesus. Amen. And so, you know, we and doors have opened for us in this community. Racism is always a problem in Rapid City and tribal and state relations, but the Lord has given the Miracle Center favor, and we know it's just all undeserved favor. And I wish when people said, oh, God's favor, I wish they would say undeserved favor, you know. And I tell you what, you know, so, you know, even recently, I'll share something with you, something really cool as a testimony. I'm now being considered, I shared this with our church last night, they thought it was real cool too. I'm now being considered to, I may be playing Crazy Horse on a 6-part miniseries on the Discovery Channel. Praise the Lord. I know, you know, and how that came about was a friend called me, and they said about a month ago and said, hey, I hope you're not mad at me, but this casting company out of Albuquerque, they're looking for somebody to play Crazy Horse on a show called The West. The same people who did The Men Who Built America, seen that on Discovery, are doing that. And they said, I sent them your picture, and now they want to talk to you. So I said, okay, so I sent, we contacted it, and I sent them an audition, and then they called me back. And said that now the director wanted to do an audition over Skype. And so I met the director over Skype, had the audition with him, and he said, well, you're back in 2 weeks, so Saturday will be 2 weeks. So I'm being considered for that. And so, you know, I told our church, I said, just to get this far is good enough for me. You know, because it reminded me, one of the verses I stand on is this, because of my past, and because, you know, the felonies on my record, you know, many places they should have denied me to be in those places where God has used the past to open those doors. And I tell you, if you have a past that's maybe blemished, I tell you, God will use that to open up doors for you. He uses people like you and me. Amen. The base things. People that ain't wise, He uses us. Amen. He says, to confound the world. And so, you know, out of all the pastors in Rapid City, and I would say we are the smallest church in Rapid City. I think I would say that. You know, and I was chosen to bless Main Street Square when it opened up in Rapid City. And now it's downtown, the big square down there, of all the pastors. But one verse I always stand on, I always encourage our people to stand on, is in Ecclesiastes chapter 9. God, he says, the race isn't given to the swift. He said, or the battle to the strong. He said, or even men of skill. So, hey, if you don't have skill, if you're not strong, hey, you're qualified. Amen. You know, and he says, but, he says, time and chance happen to them all. And what that means is God will put you in the right place at the right time. Amen. To receive from him.
Amen.
I tell you, no matter where you are, amen. A poor Indian boy who grew up in Lakota homes, you know, God will find him. Now I'm rich, and so are you. Amen.
Amen.
And find him and say, hey, we're considering you to play Crazy Horse. Amen. I've had the keys to the U.S. Bank here. Many open doors. I've had boards here in Rapid of nonprofits ask me to sit on their board, and I tell them no. Today, on all things to Jesus, no boasting in Quincy, is all Jesus. I have many speaking engagements that just no, 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 because I love being here. Amen.
Amen.
But I tell you,